You're listening to the Cars of Carlisle Network, podcast episode number 122, Corvettes of Carlisle 2020.
Cars of Carlisle is your favorite internationally downloaded podcast about all things automotive. Darren and his CFC team are ever searching for interesting automotive happenings, real stories about real car people, and fun features to inform and entertain you. Each week, the Cars of Carlisle crew brings you show topics ranging from car shows to team adventures to auto racing weekends to behind-the-scenes human interest stories from car nuts that live across town, across the country, or even across the globe. Come join the road trip.
Today, join us for the recap of the weekend spent enjoying the 2020 Corvettes at Carlisle show. Professed to be the largest, most fun-filled Corvette event anywhere on the planet, thousands of Corvettes, with representation from all eight generations, visit the Pennsylvania Mid-State each August. Corvettes at Carlisle brings America's sports car fans together to celebrate the fantastic fiberglass beauties we all know. It's time to place your bets. So, let's get revved up.
Hello and welcome back, Cubers, to your favorite informative automotive podcast. I am your trusted host, Darren, and to my right, Scott.
Hello, everybody.
We, out of the 4 days at the Corvettes of Carlisle event this weekend, we spent two better parts of the day, over 2 days of that Friday and Saturday, and the weather wasn't exactly cooperative. In fact, on Friday, wasn't it, there was a tornado warning in the area?
There was, but before that it was great because it was a little overcast, a little breeze, so it wasn't as sweltery hot as
light drizzle.
Yeah, but, it was fine.
Yeah, it was a great weekend and had, as always, super time. I was able to take my Z06 and just meet some great people. In fact, of course, we got to hang out down at the autocross track. I always enjoy that. You know, the rolling exhaust this year. The engine rev tribute, always on Saturday at noon.
Always great.
Super day when, of course, that's sent up to Chip Miller. But just all around, really, even in light of the current world situation, we heard from a couple people that they were really glad that it was happening. It was good to be back out. Everyone was glad to see each other. People were, for the most part, doing good part, you know, doing their part with keeping
the good separation and everything. Yeah. It was good, yes.
But very well done. In fact, met some really great people you're going to hear from throughout this episode. Just people we talked to, we liked their cars and what struck up a conversation and wanted to share that with you. One that comes to my mind, we can start with this one, Scott, was Joe Vera. He was out of upstate New York or from New York, and he was, how we found him and looked for him actually is earlier in the day.
We got there.
Yeah, it was like we were saying to him later, it was like the Pied Piper.
Yeah, and we heard an engine from the middle of nowhere and we were trying to follow it.
Big 502 blown cubic inch. I mean, this 502 cubic inch blown with a high rise. Man, I mean, just huge blower on this thing, gold plated.
We'd get glimpses of it and could hear it, so we kind of walked to follow it, and then we lost it.
Yep. And then we ended up finding him. So finding him. He and his son were there, and Joe, what a great guy. Really appreciated him telling us about his one of a kind 72. Pearl white, had the gold flake in it, and being in under the one pavilion, the lighting was a little hard. It was a little flat to see to appreciate the gorgeous paint.
And if you like what you hear about it, it's for sale.
That's right. But just you'll hear over the 3 decades plus that Joe's been putting this love of this vehicle, and this has been his canvas. He's done so much work to it. It has purple accents and 703 horsepower. I mean, this thing is brutal. But anyhow, let's
sharp.
Let's go talk to Joe.
Okay, I acquired the car in March of 1982. My mother worked for GE at the time, and her boss, Alan Trexler, was a Corvette collector. And he had two Corvettes, of which he was selling this one. So my mother told me about it, and I ended up buying the car. And it was triple black bone stock when I bought it. And over the 38 years, this is what you see now. But I got the car through word of mouth from my mother.
That pearl white is just
It's pearl white with a gold flake and the pink and purple flames. You can't really see it now in the light, but you know, if you put your light with the phone up to it, you can see the sparkle and the pearl.
Wow, okay.
This is bad lighting for it.
Yeah.
Hey, step.
He's like, get your hands.
It's a blown 502, 703 horse. It has HEI electronic magneto, which is the looks of a magneto, if people know what magnetos are. But it has HEI internals, so it's treatable. So I always loved the little calves, since I was a little kid.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a 671 blower, Edelbrock Pulse aluminum heads, 9.5 to 1 compression
motor.
Have you
tracked it? I mean, have you taken it down the strip at all?
No. I can't torture it like that. I'll take it out on the street and torture it, but I won't take it down the track.
Yeah.
It's got 29, 15, 15 tires in the rear, non-tubbed. Leather upholstery, as you can see. The underneath is completely detailed, just like the top.
Oh, wow. And the gold that you've gotten.
That's real 24 karat.
I was going to say, that's amazing.
That's 24 karat gold. I guess that's kind of what makes it unique.
I was going to say it's...
But hard to sell, too, because it's kind of outdated. Yeah, you know, so that's, you know, I think that's a little of a setback selling the car. Not too many people are into the gold, but at the time, I did the car early to middle 2000s.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I was into, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't turn back time. I have no regrets whatsoever.
No.
And
where are you based out of?
Fishkill, New York.
Okay.
Fishkill, New York.
Now, do you trailer?
Yes. Yeah.
Very good. Well,
let me see. I'm really no good with words unless I'm asked.
No. This is the fact that you. I mean, if you had to guess how many man hours you put into this car, just a rough estimate.
You know what? I can't even put a number on it because I just
staggering, probably.
Right, exactly. I get an idea and I do it.
Okay.
You know.
So it's been your canvas.
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. For 38 years, it was my canvas. That was perfectly put.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Well, it's gorgeous. It really is.
Thank you.
And it is truly a head turner. I know the fact that we talked earlier when I walked up. You can hear you the whole way across the fairgrounds. It's gorgeous that way. I mean, just the sound of it is so intoxicating.
That's why I don't put the mufflers back in. My son keeps telling me, Dad, it's too loud. Put the mufflers back in.
It's intoxicating.
No.
It's intoxicating.
No, because that's what calls the people.
Yes, it does.
Something like this has to be loud.
Big old gnarly side pipes.
And it is very streetable. It is. Mm-hmm. You can take it out for a nice half-hour drive.
I believe it.
It just doesn't like getting stuck in traffic. It's a thoroughbred. Mm-hmm. It needs to run.
Is it cammed up heavy?
A little bit. Mm-hmm. It's not that. It's between the smell of the exhaust, the no mufflers, and the heat in the car. Uncomfortable.
You can't even touch the tunnel, I'm sure. I mean, transmission tunnel probably.
Oh, yeah. No. It's not that bad. It's just get a little uncomfortable in there. But, you know, there's no reason for me to get stuck in traffic. That's
no.
why I'm 5 miles up the road here, but I still trail it to the show because I know Fridays and Saturdays leaving.
Stop and go.
I mean, I don't know about this year. There probably won't be traffic, but because of the rain, I trail it. If there weren't cold and rain, I would have drove the car.
I agree.
You know, there's probably not going to be much traffic.
Well, Joe, I hope you have good luck selling it. I know you want to do, a C2 Resto? Is that what you're looking
C2
at?
C2 or C3 Resto or Cobra. That's what's on my list.
Okay.
On my list. Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm hoping the best for you.
Well, I appreciate it.
Thank you so much, man. Okay, we're back to Studio A. And another, in fact... This being a show that's just all about, like all the others, of course, but just about the cars. It's so neat that you have thousands of people descending upon Carlisle to appreciate all eight generations of the Corvette. A lot more C8s this year. Last year it was Chevy introducing, and then this year you actually had owners with their vehicles.
And then you have the area where there's the Carlisle Blue.
Yes, that's a great segue. In fact, we... they have the 1 year they did the Carlisle Blue, a tribute to Carlisle events. It's a light blue. If you haven't seen it, Google it. 1 year only. It was 2012, and we were walking up that row, as Scott was mentioning, and started talking to a great couple out of the Baltimore area. In fact,
they come up every year.
He works for NASA, and super, super couple, Larry Sears and Pat Sears. They told us about their 2012 Carlisle Blue C6 Grand Sport convertible. Beautiful with the silver rally stripes, and they had like 36,000 miles on the odometer. Mm-hmm. They enjoy it. They drive it.
And it's one of a few
mm-hmm.
that they say they cannot get rid of because
right.
you know different people in the family say they can't get rid of.
They have other vets, but this one means a lot to them. So let's hear it directly from the Sears family. Hey, Cubers, this is Darren, and I am on the show field, and I am heading out at a 2012 Carlisle Blue Grand Sport convertible, and I'm with Larry and Pat Sears. Yes. Guys, thanks for taking
the
time.
Hi.
Yeah.
Well, love your car. Love the color, and when we got to talking here, I was asking you, did you buy it for the Carlisle name, or did you buy it for the...
Well, it happened to be both for us, because we both like Carlisle a whole lot, been coming here for years and years, and the blue is pretty...
It's gorgeous, yeah. It's so unique. You don't see anything.
That's the whole thing. There's not a lot of them. We had Laguna Blues and what was the other Nassau one? Nassau Blues.
Both are nice, yeah.
And when we saw this, we said, yeah, we can do that. That's different.
Very nice. So you bought it new and from Kerbeck.
Yeah, Kerbeck. Yep.
What month in 12 did you buy? Or did you buy it in 11?
We bought it in 12 because we just saw it on the lot and just loved it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it was August the 12th.
Very nice.
It's got 36,000 miles on it.
That means you've enjoyed it, which I'm glad to hear.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Yeah. Any big road trips planned? I mean, I know under the pandemic situation, things are a little bit tight.
Yeah, most of our things were canceled due to the pandemic.
That's true. But you came up from Baltimore today, for the here all weekend then?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Do you have a favorite part of Carlisle? Just the town itself, or just the experience every year?
No, the experience every year. We come up for the fall and the spring, flea markets, and also the Chevrolet Nationals.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it, really.
Okay.
But, I don't know if you know, but it was the only year they made the color was this 2012.
I'm glad you said, especially for the listeners of the podcast. Yeah, Everybody knows that,
right.
But it's a pretty amazing thing that there is a GM color named after this town and this event. So
yeah, it was actually dedicated to Carlisle for the Corvette shows.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's neat.
It's very cool. Any other final word? I'll let you guys have the final say on anything.
No, I'll tell you, the new ones are growing on me.
Yes.
I like that blue one right over there.
It's kind of like that Miami blue, right?
Yeah.
It's like
a
bright blue, yeah.
I like that blue.
Mm-hmm. Well, they have a real, because of the mid-engine, that European look.
Yeah.
It could pass as a Ferrari from afar. So.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Definitely come at headlights.
Yeah. Yeah,
but
I hope you keep this one.
Oh, we have a 2000.
Our daughter loves this one. She's selfish.
Good. She's going to put her feet in. Yeah, dig her heels in on
this. She's in her early 30s, so let me tell you, she definitely.
All right.
Do not sell it.
Good for her.
We also have a Sebring Orange.
Oh, I love that
2019 Z06 convertible home.
That's a great car.
We don't bring it up here.
Okay. Just because you keep low miles on it? Or
no, just because that comes.
Oh, you want to bring Carlisle to Carlisle.
Yeah,
so.
That's it. Right.
Well, Sebring Orange, that's one of my favorites.
Yeah, it is.
That's gorgeous. And you got the last year, the 7, which is excellent, too.
And Chris Wells Chevrolet and Mike Furman, he's a big Corvette guy.
Okay.
He's down here with Ron Feller's driving school.
Yeah.
He goes with them all the time. He's been down to play a lot. He's a big Corvette guy.
Okay.
He sold that to us, and he was able to get it for us where other dealers could not. Because they didn't know about the, I think it was a $508 markup, because we got gray interior with the orange exterior and a gray convertible top, which makes it very unique.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then I added gray stripes down the thing too.
That sounds beautiful.
But it's a nice car.
Two up and over the top.
Yeah,
the hood all the way over. Okay.
All the way back
nice.
The front.
Beautiful.
Down the waterfall.
Good. Down, yeah. Perfect.
It is.
You did it right then. That's all that matters.
But we like this one best.
I understand. Well, thank you so much for coming to Carlisle. It's great talking to you.
Yep.
Pat, thanks for your time.
Yep.
Thanks you for your time. So
yep,
good.
Thank you.
All right.
Great day.
You too.
Yep.
Okay. Thanks to Larry and Pat. Great to have met you and have you be part of the Cars of Carlisle family going forward.
It's great to hear us from the Sears.
Leave it to Scott for the pun.
Okay.
Now it's time for more fun.
Moving right on.
That's right. Then we talked to a gentleman whose uncle has, I think he said, 30-plus cars in his collection, one of which was a C1. It was a 1961 Corvette convertible. Beautiful. It was black with a white cove and
really,
the red interior.
Really nice.
From afar, I mean, it just, big white walls. Looks like a tuxedo. Just super sharp, classic C1 Corvette. And we walked up to Walter Krieg and started talking to him. And he can tell you a little bit more about that beautiful C1 convertible. I'm here with Walter Krieg, and we're standing behind your uncle's 61. You want to tell us a little bit about this C1?
The C1?
Beautiful black with that white cove. I love it.
He works in heating and air conditioning. He installed a paint booth for a body shop near him. And that's how the guy paid for the paint booth install.
Wow.
On the streets.
Okay.
Now, the car is 75% original. Only painted was the trunk and the hood.
Okay.
Were painted. The motor was all done up. 90% of the car is all chrome underneath.
Now, what kind of mill is it?
The 289 poured out.
Okay,
you know,
gotcha.
Cam and everything else.
Okay.
You know?
I love the wide white walls. I mean, that's dressed up nice.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
The interior's original. The wheels are original. All the chromes, I believe, is original.
Okay. And how many years has he had it?
He's had it about 25 years.
Okay. Wow. I see it's on ply tires. I mean, it's... Yep. Wow. Does he show it much? Just,
no.
Just once
no.
a year?
And yeah, he'll take it for a ride once a year, and that's about it.
Okay. All right.
You know.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Now, do you enjoy driving it?
I don't drive it much. Okay. I have a trailer, so I brought it down on the trailer. It's hard to drive with the horsepower.
That's
you know?
True. That's true.
Yeah.
Beautiful car. Mm. Well, thank you for telling us. Anything else you want to tell us a little bit about it? I mean, I love the white Cove, the black. It's such a tuxedo-looking car.
Yeah.
It's gorgeous.
I mean, it's the second time it's been out in about 15 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, got a little bit of rain today for it. So.
Yeah.
Well, Walter, thank you so
thank
much
you
for
very
doing
much.
It.
Well, we had a great time at the Corvette show. In fact, let's go to the phones and talk to Public Relations Manager Mike Garland to get a wrap-up from the perspective of Carlisle Events.
Corvettes at Carlisle was a fun weekend for the folks that came in 2020. And certainly, Darren, this was a unique year. I've said it once, I'll say it again. But to have the people that either purchased a ticket or registered for the fun field or signed up to be a vendor... As a company, Carlisle Events, we cannot thank those people enough. The displays were really cool. The 50-year display of 1970 Corvettes, and then the Chip's Choice showcase in Building T, where we spotlighted the best of Bloomington Gold. We want to thank the folks at Bloomington Gold for their help on this. And if you're a Corvette lover, they've got their event planned coming up in early September at Lucas Oil Stadium, the home of the Indianapolis Colts. So some more car show fun on your horizon. And speaking of car show fun at Carlisle, we're back at it with Fall Carlisle starting September 30th and running through October 4th. And you can also check out an in-person auction October 1st and 2nd at the Carlisle Expo Center. Now, if you want to be part of that auction event, you have to be a registered bidder or seller to attend in 2020. We're doing our part to be compliant with COVID-19 measures, which include capacities on indoor gatherings. So again, you have to be a registered buyer or seller to be part of the fall auction. But Fall Carlisle itself, September 30th through October 4th. And Darren, you and I will get together again between now and then to talk about all that fall is going to have to offer. But you can check out the photos from Corvettes at Carlisle through the Carlisle Events Flickr page. Just Google Carlisle Events and Flickr, and that'll get you where you need to be. Or you can check out some photos and video on social media as well. CarlisleEvents.com. Learn all about what we've got going on. Have a good rest of the episode, Darren.
All right. We are back. Scott, any other reflections you wanted to share just from our time at the weekend over at Carlisle?
Just what you mentioned about it. I mean, still amazing to see the amount of people that are still coming out in a year such as what we have. But again, I think everybody needs the feeling of communing and getting together, and it's quite the fellowship for these people that they have planned on every year. So it was a great gathering, more than enough space. People were, you know, very respectful of distancing and that sort of thing. So it was good all around, and I think it was really well received. It was well attended, and I think it was another great Corvettes of Carlisle show.
It was
perfect.
Hats off to Carlisle Events. I heard a lot of person on the street type feedback from many people. They were saying, as we mentioned a little bit earlier, that they appreciated the fact that they had an event to come to, that there's a lot of effort put into keeping everyone well and safe. And at the same time, as you said, Scott, enjoying what we all love. And people have been pent up in their houses. They're really missing the social aspect. And you saw a lot of clubs and folks that had traveled into the Central Pennsylvania area together under, of course, their big umbrellas or their big temporary tents at the back of their cars and just hanging out, catching up. And that's good to see.
They don't care. They're diehard. They're there no matter what.
Yep, they enjoy it.
And as a little preview segue, we did get to run into Andrea Randolph and get to see her car up close and in person.
2019 C7 Z06 that she was, on Friday, she was adding the splitter and side skirts, and she was doing some other bits to it to personalize it and make it even meaner than it already is. Always great to catch up with Andrea.
And a beautiful car.
Yes.
It really is great.
In fact, we have an interview with her. She is a very proud, and I'm glad to see there are more of that, but car owners, Corvette owners, female, and she loves her Corvettes and knows how to drive them. And it's going to be a great interview coming up next week. So that's, like you said, a little bit of a preview.
A little bit of a teaser for it. So.
Yep. Episode
122.
That'll be around the corner before you know it. Well, any other things that you wanted to mention for everyone? I think just the fact that this, other than Fall Carlisle, this was the last car-based event. And we'll have, of course, the flea market and Fall Carlisle, which is also very big in its own right. That'll be coming up. But this was, in a way, kind of bittersweet in a sense. The end of the 2020 car show season, in a way.
But fortunately, there was a 2020 car show season.
Yeah, I'll tell you, compared to what's happening in a lot of other places in the U.S. and around the world.
Or what was anticipated even a couple months ago in the projection. Yeah, I'm happy that these at least happened.
So we have to be thankful for what was.
Yep, absolutely.
Oh, good. Well, I really appreciate everyone being part of this show. Thank you for continuing to support us by doing so with rating us 5 stars, subscribing, sharing, getting the word out, particularly with car clubs and anyone else that you know that loves all things automotive. Please get the word out. We want to continue to grow.
And join on iTunes, because then it automatically downloads to you. It adds to the automatic downloads. It adds to everything. It helps us as well as helping you. So please just, you know, join and subscribe on iTunes. It's free to subscribe. So just, you know, make sure you go through that process. It would be really, really helpful for just a couple of minutes of your time.
Good point, Scott. And I also want to put a big shout out to our headline OEM dealership sponsor, and that is, of course, Porsche Mechanicsburg. A big thank you to Nick Ramagosa. You heard from him last week in that episode 120, but we are really excited to be working with Porsche Mechanicsburg again. Just the fact that they are the Central Pennsylvania leader and, of course, all things coming out of Stuttgart. The new facility, as you heard from last week's episode, truly state-of-the-art, very impressive, and it's going to just be an immaculate building that I think rivals any of the nicest office buildings, architecturally and everything. It's beautiful.
And you can check them out. You can search them online or just go to Cars of Carlisle webpage on the sponsors, and there's a direct link to take you to them as well. Check out them. You'll be able to see the updates on the facility, find out when it's going to be opening, see any type of contact information you may need for them.
Yep, so if you're in the market for pre-owned or new 911, whatever it might be, just check them out. I know they have Macans and of course, the all-electric Taycan that we talked about last week. Be sure to check out Porsche Mechanicsburg. Well, Scott, thanks for going along to the events.
Oh, no, it was great.
It was a lot of fun having you along. We got to hit that fairgrounds, and we walked it all over how many times? I don't even know. We got our steps in for sure. So great to have you come back. We look forward to seeing you next week. As we said, we're going to have a female Corvette owner, Andrea Randolph. So be sure to join us again next Tuesday. We are so glad to have you part of the Cars of Carlisle network and family. So for now, I'll say drive well.
Be well.
Take care.